So we're here with Eric van Vulpen from Analytics and HR. Eric, can you introduce yourself?
Yeah, of course. I'm Eric van Vulpen. I'm the founder of Analytics and HR. We started about 2 and something years ago just writing about how to do people analytics in the most practical way. And that has grown quite a bit. We launched the HR Analytics Academy because a lot of people started asking us, hey, where can we learn more about analytics? And that has been the journey.
If we look into the HR analytics space, what are the main things that you see happening there at the moment?
Oh, that's a good question. There's a lot happening.
All right.
And we can talk about this for hours. I think that the main three things that are happening is that companies see the importance of analytics. Analytics has kind of blown up in the past few years, and companies really see the importance of data-driven HR. However, companies are struggling with implementing analytics. A lot of companies try to get their data on a certain level, try to get descriptive reporting so they know what's going on in the organization, but companies are still struggling with really getting the most value out of their data.
Right.
So yeah, you can have a dashboard and you can see what your turnover is, or you can see what the percentage of unwanted turnover is, the high potential that are leaving that you really don't want to leave. But the question is still, what do you do with this? And making that next step is something that companies are really struggling with at the moment.
So we're talking about, when you say the next step, we're talking about going from descriptive to predictive?
Yeah, that's exactly it. Going from having a dashboard with data that you can just look at and maybe learn something from, but it's just a static data from today and yesterday and a year before this, towards, hey, what will happen in the future? Because if you can anticipate or predict what will happen in the future, you know, you will get value, and you can anticipate, you can create policies that will also impact the future. So those predictions are something that companies are striving for,
yes,
logically, because that's where the real value is, but it's still very hard to achieve.
All right. And I believe you mentioned two other ones, right?
Yeah, that's true. I think the second one that we're really seeing is the appetite for analytics is really great. And a lot of people are now trying to actively develop the skills to do analytics within their own organization. And that has been an uptick that I think shows that the market is now ready for, hey, we know that analytics adds value, we have a perception of what's going on, now how do we start doing it? A third trend we're really seeing is an uptick in interest in more advanced techniques. Something that's talked about a lot is now continuous listening. A book I read not too long ago, they only used structural equation modeling, a very advanced statistical technique. There's also in the scientific literature more and more written about more advanced techniques that we can apply in analytics. And I think that also gives us hope that even though a lot of companies, as I said, are struggling with getting from reporting to real analytics, there's in the analytics space actually a lot of progress being made with scientific research, with books, with business literature that goes more towards the advanced approaches.
When we talk about people analytics, what are the big themes that you're expecting to see in 2019?
That's a good question. Like in every year they say that the next year will be the year of people analytics. I've never made that prediction, but I think 2019 might actually be
all
the
right
year of people analytics. I think there are some major trends going on. Adoption of people analytics will continue. The importance of metrics will also continue to grow, simply in terms of importance. And I think one major trend that we're seeing, a lot of people talk about continuous listening, about continuous analytics. I think the view on people analytics will be more holistic in a way, and holistic is always a very, very, you know, floaty kind of word. What are you talking about when you speak about holistic people analytics? It's really the notion that people analytics doesn't happen in isolation. That you need strategic leadership, you need influence, you need to implement your analytics findings. The integration within the larger organization, the culture change in the organizations will be very important. And one last part that hooks into this is digital HR. The notion that all your systems produce the data that you do your analytics on. So if we design those systems in a better way, the data that comes out will also be better structured. And if we design our systems in a way that mirrors the employee journey, all the critical points, our data will reflect that, and then our analytics will be much more focused on adding value, will be much more accurate. And I think that's also one of the major trends that, that I expect in 2019 will, but that we'll see in 2019.
All right. Thank you very much, Eric.
My pleasure, Nili.